Recording in progress.
Moe, if you would like to ask the first question, please.
Yeah, thank you, Moisha from the news. Steve, welcome to Pakistan. My question is, how deeply you miss captaincy, Australian captaincy, and if ever you get opportunity, would you like to lead the team again? Thank you.
No, I'm happy where everything's at the moment. I think Patrick's doing a terrific job. I'm enjoying being his deputy and helping him in any way that I can have success. I think we really worked well together over the summer, and now we've got an opportunity to work together away from home, and I'm looking forward to that challenge as well.
Shaheen Hashmi, please.
Hi, Steve. Shaheen from Agence France Press, AFP. Steve, did you ever wish playing in Pakistan or miss Pakistan as a venue on your illustrious batting chart?
Of course. It's obviously great to be back here in Pakistan playing some cricket. It's the first time a lot of us have been here. We're really excited. We know how passionate Pakistanis are about cricket, and we're excited to get into it in a few days' time. We've got our first training session today where we have an opportunity to see the facilities, see the wicket we're going to be playing on, and the guys are incredibly excited about being here and bringing cricket back to Pakistan.
Mel Farrell, please.
Thanks, Brian. Hi, Steve. Just knowing how meticulously you like to prepare before a test match, just wondering what these next few days are going to be like for you, seeing as the conditions, the pitch, the surroundings are completely new. Is it going to be a case where they're going to have to prise you out of the nets in the afternoon to finish training?
Oh, perhaps. It's obviously my first time playing here, so getting accustomed to the conditions is really important, and having the ability to adapt to whatever we're facing out in the middle. So I'm looking forward to training today. It's the first session back for me facing fast bowling. I've obviously recovering from my concussion. I've faced some sidearm and some spinners, so I have the opportunity to face some fast bowlers today, which I'm looking forward to. And I'm looking forward to the next 3 days of prep before we get started on Friday.
Tom Decent, please.
Hey, Steve, just wanted to ask about the head. Just like, are you pretty sure you're going to be playing that first test? Like, do you have to get through anything in the next few days? You said a bit of fast bowling stuff, and obviously that's your third concussion. Any sort of concerns there? And secondly, the other question just about around the Ashton Agar stuff, your thoughts on that, and sort of whether you've had to deal with any online stuff, and how the group's feeling about all that?
The head's progressed really well the last few days, so I'm feeling in a good space. I've done a lot of stuff where I've got my heart rate up to a good amount, brought it back down, and that's part of the sort of protocols of getting back to playing, and had a couple of good hits in Melbourne before we came away. But yeah, today's obviously just about ticking off facing fast bowling, and once that's done, then everything should be fine. So it's progressed along nicely. In regards to the Ashton Agar stuff, I think we're aware of social media and the unfortunate events that can occur on platforms across social media. So we've got a lot of people here working with us. We trust our security and everyone involved, and we're feeling incredibly safe here in Pakistan, and we'll be guided by our security and the people that we trust around us.
Pete Lawler, please.
Hi, Steve. I don't mean to be impolite, but the last couple of years has been a bit of a drop-off in form, but also there's been a drop-off in the amount of cricket you play. Are you a player that feels you go better when you're playing constantly up to?
Yeah, absolutely. I love getting in a role and being able to play a lot of cricket and just finding my groove. So Yeah, it's been an odd couple of years, really, hasn't it? We this is our first away tour since the Ashes in 2019, which is obviously hard to fathom. But you know, we're excited again about playing some cricket away and challenging ourselves in foreign conditions, and that's something I certainly pride myself on. Is my performance away from home. So obviously, the last away tour I performed really well in the Ashes, and hopefully I can replicate something similar in this series. I'm feeling good at the moment. You know, I'm in a nice place, so hopefully a good preparation the next few days, and then yeah, hopefully some big runs this series.
Thanks, mate.
Zach Gates, please.
Yeah, g'day Steve, all the best for the series, mate.
Thank you.
Just wanted to ask about your bowling. What do you think of the prospect of maybe rolling your arm over a little bit more in the conditions over in Pakistan, where, you know, it's probably going to be a bit more docile?
Yeah, I'll probably have a bit of a roll the next few days, but we've obviously got quite a few spinners on this tour. We're kind of not sure what conditions we'll get yet. We'll have probably a better idea after we have a look at the surface today and get out to training at the ground. So I think we've got all bases covered, but yeah, certainly if I'm needed to have a roll, then yeah, last time I bowled in a game, they came out pretty well. So we'll see how we go.
Andrew Ramsey, please. Yeah,
I think that's something that I've prided myself on over my career, is being able to adapt quickly on the go to whatever the circumstance or the surface in front of me. I think that's really important to be able to do that really quickly on the go. So yeah, the next few days will be good, being able to have a hit on the surfaces. I don't know whether they're going to replicate what we're going to get out in the middle. We'll wait and see, but yeah, I'm just excited to be here in Pakistan and bringing cricket back here, Test cricket back here, as an Australian team. So, you know, I think it's going to be a terrific series. We're all excited, and I think we're going to have to work really hard and adapt on the go to whatever, you know, is thrown at us.
Lockie McCurdy, please.
Thanks, guys. Hey, Steve. Obviously, it's been a while since you guys have played overseas in Test matches. I think 2019 is the last time, and obviously had a good record there. Overall, your record away from home has been very strong. Is it good to be able to get out from Australia and play overseas again?
Yeah, for sure. No, I love playing on different surfaces and all the different challenges of playing in different places around the world. They all create, you know, they've all got different aspects to them, whether you're playing in England on wickets that seem, playing in the subcontinent on spinning wickets or what have you. So, no, I'm excited. Obviously, the summer was pretty tough in terms of wickets. The wickets had a fair amount of grass and there was a fair amount of seam movement on them. So, again, we'll just have to see what we're faced with out in the middle and adapt accordingly. And, I'm looking forward to that challenge.
Arthur Feroz, please.
Thank you, mate. Welcome to Pakistan, Steve. Obviously, playing against Pakistan would be quite near to your career because you have made the debut against Pakistan and you're a part of the historic tour. You've played 9 test matches against Pakistan with a healthy record. Can you tell us your experience of playing against Pakistan, the talent, Babar Azam, Azhar Ali, Naseem Shah, Shaheen Shah? Tell us your views, how have you taken the team Pakistan?
Sorry, what was the last bit of your question there? I couldn't hear.
Tell us about the views of you playing against Pakistan, the talent Pakistan has.
Look, I think they've got a terrific squad, a lot of quality players. you know, all throughout their lineup. So playing against Pakistan in their home conditions is going to be a terrific challenge. We're all really excited. We obviously played against them a couple of years ago back home. So we saw quite a few of the players there, and there seems to be a lot of terrific players coming through the Pakistan system. So they're a great squad, and we're going to have to play really well over here if we're going to beat them.
We've got three more now, please. Henry Peters, Wajahat Kazmi, and Idris Malik. Henry, first of all, please.
Oh, g'day, Steve. You mentioned earlier that you're feeling good, but it has been a strange couple of years. It's been a little while since your last century. Are you concerned about your form heading in? How do you feel about that?
No, I'm feeling good. I feel I'm in a good place. I'm hitting the ball nicely. So, no sort of concerns from me. Just go about my business as usual, prepare really well. Hopefully hit a lot of balls the next few days and find a nice rhythm going into the first test on Friday.
Wajahat Kazmi, please. Hello, Wajahat. Just put your microphone on if you can hear me, please. Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Thank you.
Hi, Steve. Welcome to Pakistan. You guys are starting the practice session from today, and we'll also get a good look at the wicket. Pakistan's team has been in considerable good form for the last some time, and with the kinds of Babar, Rizwan, and Shaheen in sight. How is Australia planning on tackling Pakistan in Pakistan?
Like you said, all those players are of high quality. They're world-class players. So, for us, it's hard to tell just yet. We've got to see the surface that we're going to be playing on and play according to that. And I think that's the best way to play away from home is, playing according to the surface that's in front of you and getting the right tempo of the game at certain times. It's certainly different to back in Australia playing in the subcontinent. So, we're excited about the challenge. They're a terrific side, and we look forward to getting this test series started in a couple of days' time.
Just finally, Idris Malik, please.
Thank you, Brian. Welcome, Steve, in Pakistan. Definitely, you have a good record in the Asian pitches, and you are in a very good mood. But there is there something special in your mind about when you think about the Shaheen and Harris? Do you need something special? And on a lighter note, I just want to ask, how is Islamabad treating you? Like, they served you with a food. Do you like it?
Yeah, it's been great here so far in Islamabad. The hospitality's been outstanding. We had a team barbecue together last night, and it was amazing. The food was sensational. So it's been really good so far. In terms of Shaheen and Harris, I think that you asked about, that they're both terrific bowlers. They bowl with nice pace, and they seem as though they're progressing really nicely in their careers. So they're quality players, and we look forward to coming up against good players. So we're excited.
We've actually just got a little bit of extra time, so we've got two more questions, Louis Cameron and Zach Gates, and then we'll have to call it a day, I'm afraid. Louis, first of all.
Thanks for fitting me in, Murgis. Steve, I just wanted to ask about the concussion when you got it fielding in that Sri Lanka series. Was that a bit of a first for you, I guess, kind of getting it in the field, first of all? And just can you talk us through what the side effects might have been over the last few weeks?
Yep. So I think I actually knocked myself out for a couple of seconds there. And then when I came to, I was, pretty in a bit of a weird state, and I knew straight away that I was likely concussed, so after having quite a few knocks to the head. So just sort of headaches, a bit of drowsiness. A couple of Fridays ago I had a vertigo incident where I was struggling for a bit that day, but got all the had the Epley's maneuver, if you guys know what that is, and got the crystals back where they're supposed to be in the inner ear. So it's not a very comfortable place to be, I'll tell you that. But after that, things sort of settled down and progressed really nicely. I've been able to do all the exercise stuff that I've needed to do to get myself back to that ready to play state. So everything's going well, and yeah, I'm looking forward to hitting some balls today against some bowlers.
Yeah, hi Steve. Obviously you'll be playing a T20 over in Pakistan as well. I just wanted to ask, what are your thoughts on yourself as the future T20 player, and what do you make of calls from a couple of former players that, you know, you're questioning the T20 side is under pressure? I know Shane Warne said that and Mark Walls said that. What are your thoughts?
Oh, look, everyone's entitled to their opinion. You know, I know my place and my role in the T20 team for Australia, and whilst my performances perhaps haven't been as good as they as I would have liked over the last little bit, you know, I still know I can play the format when I'm playing well, and you know, there's a few ways to skin a cat. Obviously, you've got your powerful guys that can clear the rope at will, and I think the way I play my best is, you know, I don't overthink things. I hit the gaps, I run hard between the wickets, and I limit the amount of dot balls I face. I think that's important for me when I'm playing really well, and yeah, something that I need to continue to focus on.
Okay, everyone, thank you very much indeed for your time this morning. It's very much appreciated. Take care, and we look forward to speaking to you again tomorrow. Thank you.
Recording stopped.
Thanks.
Thanks.